Hello, I once again want to record me playing a game of chess against the computer. This time the engine I'm using is Kritter 1.6. It is probably slightly better than the Houdini 1.5 engine. Not as good as Houdini 3, but since it is free, I think it might be the best free engine right now, so I will give a try to see how long I can survive against it. I start with d4, pawn to d4, and the engine, as you can see, not very typical opening, I think, and in this case I can get even more center control by really safely playing this c pawn, because since it isn't challenged yet by the d pawn of my opponent, I have more than enough time to protect it, and so it is like in the queen's gambit, but it isn't a gambit at all in this case, since I can simply protect it. So the computer obviously wants to fianchetto hits its bishop. That is what it's called when you make here this little pocket on the side with this pawn, and then put it here so it can control the long diagonal. In this case it would have been better if I hadn't played this pawn here, but I couldn't have known before, so now I think I will start developing my pieces and only do more pawn moves when it's really necessary. Yeah, I will use the knight here. If you wonder why the computer reacts so fast, it is not that I have restricted him from thinking. It is because I found out how to use opening books for all engines in this case, for Arena 3, which is the program I use to play chess. I only record the window where I actually play, but the whole Arena interface is a little bigger than that. So, but let's get back to the game, and now I'm thinking about if I should fianchetto myself on the for the king, but I feel that once I play, I later definitely want to play this e-pawn to e3, so it can give a solid protection of these two pawns, and in this case, if I also push the g-pawn here, then this knight has no real defense anymore, and so I want to avoid it. So I think I can play this knight now. This is a move I was actually waiting for, because now it makes sense to also protect this pawn, and the most elegant way to do this is moving the e pawn here so the knight can protect it. Computer castles. Now his king is super safe with the fianchettoed bishop and also the knight in front of it, so it's not very easy to attack, but as you might remember from my last few attempts, it isn't really easy to attack at all against such a strong AI as we are playing right now, but at least we want to get a somewhat decent opening going. One thing I'd really like him to do is playing his bishop here, but because then I would play my bishop here, which kind of forces the exchange and then allows me to develop my queen. It is a slight problem that I now can't develop this bishop anymore to outside of this mountain, so I will now develop this not develop, but move this pawn and then get the bishop here. So it's kind of defensive. The AI now started thinking for itself. It thinks during my move, so I can keep the times a little lower for when it calculates during its turn. And I think it's still strong enough when it only calculates during my turn. So now we have a little bit of tension here, and let's think what he could probably try to do now. If he would take here, then I could retake with my knight, and I think I would be fine. If he took here, then it... Yeah, I would just retake with my bishop. I'm now a little bit in Zugzwang, because I could actually pronounce it right since I am German, and it shouldn't be too hard to say Zugzwang correctly. I wanted to do this here anyways. I thought I already had, but probably my thoughts were ahead of my deeds. So he now took as expected. So I retake with the knight, and now he threatens the knight, and I hadn't actually thought about this possibility before moving there. Now let's find another good place for the knight. Okay, I see now. I will adapt this as an opening for black. Should I play once again? I hadn't actually considered that how good this combination is, because if I now move back here, he will just follow up by moving here, and then he once again has a strong foothold in my territory with his two knights. I could also get here, but then the protection of this knight is obviously not as strong as I wanted it to be, so another place to go would be here, and I already am thinking that this is the best place to move my knight to, because it doesn't block any of my pawns like it would do here, and it doesn't block this bishop, so I think it should be the best. Also here would be another possibility, but obviously after the computer playing a6, this space wouldn't be valuable anymore, so I think this is the best spot I can bring this knight to. He now protects his so he doesn't push here as I had expected, but he can do it later anytime soon, because the reason why it is necessary is that my knight isn't here. So let's see, he protects this with three pieces. The knight, the bishop, and the queen. So taking here would obviously result in simply having him gain foothold here, which I don't want. A thing I want to do first is, I need to get castled. So I play my. Wait one moment. If he takes here, then I can retake with the I can retake with the bishop, then he can retake once again with his bishop, and I would be forced to take with my pawn, which isn't as good. So